So today, we'll take the console error, build the project and make it live. To open the console, right-click anywhere, click Inspect and click Console. At the moment, you can see three errors that we need to resolve. The first one is in App Hero component, and here, instead of using class name, class has been used. So open App Hero, which is hero.js. You can search somewhere over here, class has been used. So instead of class, you can replace them to class name. Check the site again. And now we got similar issue in app themes component. So open themes.js. So again, instead of class, you can replace them to class name. Check the site again. And now we got similar issue in app block component. So open blog.js and follow the same procedure, which is use class name instead of class. Check the site. And now we can see the issue in app contact. So open contact.js. Search for class. And replace them to class name. Check the site again. And now we got only two errors over here. These errors are in app contact component. And here, instead of using the lowercase, we need to follow the camel case. So copy the camel case, go to app contact, which is contact.js, and it is in iframe. So you can simply replace over here. Check the side. And now we got just one error. Again, instead of using the lowercase, you can copy the uppercase format and replace over here. Check the side. And this time, all the error has been resolved. Now, it's time to build the project. But before that, open new tab and search create React app deployment. Click the first link, and it's a best practice to read this documentation, which will give you good idea about deployment. Since we are deploying for relative path, click building for relative path. You can copy this code and add them under package.json. You can add anywhere over here. For now, I will just add them after the version. Now it's time to replace it to the actual website URL. So let's assume this is the website URL. So I will just copy and paste it over here. Once done, we can now build the project using npm run build. Once the build is complete, you can go back to your project folder. You will see a new folder build over here. You can rename this to your project name, corporate. And this is the folder that you need to upload them in your web hosting. So make sure in your web hosting, you create a folder something like this. You can then upload your project folder and your website should look something like this. Great. This is the end of this session. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel to get more videos in the future. Thank you so much for choosing my YouTube channel to learn React Bootstrap. I will see you again next time with the next course.